Hey everyone, welcome to another Channel Fireball video. I noticed that we didn't have a historic Izzet Phoenix deck in our videos, at least I haven't found one. So I wanted to do it. It's a new deck that got a lot of new cards from Strixhaven, mainly Fateless Looting. The combination of Fateless Looting and Arclight Phoenix basically got Fateless Looting, amongst other decks, banned in Modern. So the combination is really strong. Obviously, we don't have cards like Time and Ice. But this deck has a lot of card selection, so you should be pretty good at finding phoenixes, putting them in the graveyard thanks to cards like Fateless Looting, thanks to cards like Strategic Planning, Charter Course. Brainstorm is really nice with Fabled Passage now as well, and also as a way to just protect your hand from discard, although in this deck it's not as important than other decks because all the cards are basically doing the same thing. So if somebody duresses you or Todd seizes you, your hand is usually four card draw spells or something, so it doesn't really, it's not a big deal as if you get, you know, Todd seized if you're playing something like Black White Auras and they take your Core Spirit Walker. One of the reasons why I do like this deck right now is that Blue Black Rogues is a really popular deck at the moment, and if they're milling you, if that's part of their game plan, then how about you mill some of my phoenixes? Also, Brainstorm works naturally well against somebody who's trying to mill cards on the top of your library. So, you know, there you're being attacked by Soaring Thought Thief. There's a mill two cards in the stack. Just play Brainstorm, put two bad cards you don't want, including phoenixes from the hand on the top of your library. And bam, it's gonna get milled, and you almost turn it into an Ancestral Recall. I'm gonna change a few cards around though. This is the version that I posted a deck guide about this before the set even came out. I'm going to play something very close to this, but I want to change some cards. Every time I played this deck or played against it, I thought Finale was incredibly powerful, and every time it just looked really, really good. So I'm just going to put the third one into the deck, because that card alone by itself can just bring back Phoenixes, because you just play Finale, you target, you know, something like an Opt and a Fateless Looting, and that's already three cards, right? So you bring the Phoenixes back. And another card I really liked from the new set is the 2-mana card. Let me find it. 2-mana, blue-red. How did I select the new set? I don't get, no. Mystic Lurka, oh, here's Strixhaven. It's a 2-mana multicolor card, this one, Expressive Iteration. I thought that card was really powerful. Whenever I played against this in the pre-release, it's basically 2-mana, draw, like look at three cards and draw two of them. You often play it on turn three to get a land out of it, or on turn four because you exile the land. You can play it. It says you may play the exiled cards this turn instead of cast. If it was cast, you wouldn't be able to play the lands, but because it says play, you can do that. So you usually put one of them in your hand. You exile the land, or you know, if you already have a lot of lands, you can just exile another card, and you will almost always get two spells out of this, which is really, really strong for 2-mana. So I'm pretty sure I want to put four of these into my deck, and I'm probably going to cut something like a Charter Course, maybe Strategic Planning. Not sure which one is better. I like that you can use Charter Course just to naturally draw cards. Like sometimes you'll be able to attack with your dragon or with your phoenix, and then you can play Charter Course, and it's just going to draw you two cards. But pretty sure that this card is just overall better. Pillar of Flame, Lightning Axe. I want to make sure that I have enough removal against all these creature decks like Rogues and like Green White Company that people are playing right now. Anger of the Gods, pretty good with the or not Anger of the Gods. Soldering Sun's pretty good with the cycling ability. Anger might not be as good because it also exiles your phoenix if you have it in play, which is kind of bad. Beacon Bolt, Ox, 3 Lightning Axe, Negate Spell Pierce. I'm gonna cut a few of these, as there aren't really that many decks like Elves that where you would want to have Anger right now. I think it's probably better to just have the 1-mana removal. A wild cat appears. So I'm gonna put in an extra Lightning Axe. I guess I have to change the search. extra lightning axe, and I'm gonna put in an extra pillar. Not an instant, maybe shock could be better, but I like that both of these cards, like this skill's a bigger creature, so you can have it against, you know, some like Gruul and kills a questing beast, and this exiles, which is really strong against black white auras, and even against rogues, it's a pretty useful thing to do. I feel like I should just have like one more removal spell in my deck, and I'm not also sure if I want to have a young pyromancer or if I want to have something like a soul scar mage, but let's just give it a try and we can change some cards as we go. I guess I need to figure out which one of these I'm cutting. I'll just keep one and one. Strategic planning is better though. But I do need to have a good amount of ways to get rid of Phoenix from my hand. Right now I have two axes, four Fateless Looting, and one Charter Course. That's seven. Yeah, I guess that's okay. And Brainstorm also puts it back. That should be alright. Craft. Yes. Done. All right, I'll feed my cat and we can start playing in a little bit.
Need a way to re-spark the excitement in your TCG collection? Box breaks are the way to get your hands on cards from the games you love. Learn more today at cfbboxbreaks.com or check out CFB Box Breaks on YouTube.
All right, let's go. Why is there no sound? Okay. I will mulligan this. Fateless Looting. Yeah, I mean, we're going to keep this, right? I'm going to put Finale back. And we have a Fateless Looting plus Arclight Phoenix. We only have one land, but that's okay. This is a perfectly reasonable hand. Island Go. That's a pretty cool island. All right, let's fire up the Fateless Looting while we can make sure that it actually resolves. So Phoenix definitely goes in the graveyard. I think I might just discard Brainstorm. I guess this doesn't find Phoenixes and puts them in the graveyard. That is a downside of this card. So maybe it's not definitely better than something like Strategic Planning, because that card is a lot better at finding Phoenixes and actually dumping them in the yard. Yeah, I'll get rid of Brainstorm, I think. I think all these cards are just a little bit stronger. I could have ditched one of the two mana cards and tried to go for, like, turn three, finding another red card I could play just to bring back the Phoenix, but I don't think I'm really in a rush, so just play my land here, pass the turn. If they play something, I can kill it. I probably will. Just, while they're tapped, I'll just kill this now. If I wait to try to lure them into playing Curious Obsession, they're just going to be able to counter my burn spell with a Storm Tamer anyway, so there's nothing I can do about that. The good thing is that, like, even though they might be holding a bunch of counter spells, I'm just going to be able to play three spells and bring back the Phoenix anyway, so it shouldn't change too much. I could play Sprite and a tapped land and next turn go for Iteration, put a one mana card into my hand, land, exile, and then start to play and try to play three spells. Yeah, I think that's good. Or play Finale. Finale is also good. Yeah, let's play the dragon. I could have played Steam Vents on tap, because maybe I'm going to do it anyway and I would be able to play around Sensor. But they usually don't play that card, so. The thing is, if this doesn't resolve, I probably play the land tapped. Okay, it does. So, yeah, now I play this on tap to make it a 2-2, because that's going to save me 1 point of damage anyway. Although, do I want to play the opt? I want to play three spells next turn. Yeah, I don't think so, actually. I'm gonna pass. If they had the 2-2 trickster guy, then they would be able to make me lose flying. Okay, I could have saved 3 damage as it turns out, but there was no way of knowing that. I'm not gonna block. Okay. So let's see. Let's start with the iteration, I think. Alternatively, I can start with Opt and try to find a land, and then it would be guaranteed. No, let's start with this. The downside of that is that it's very likely going to get countered, so maybe that was not great. So we're going to put this on the bottom. Fabled Passage. All right, so now I can play Looting, hopefully find another Phoenix. I think I might actually even attack. I mean, Finale is the best out of all these, right? Yeah, I think I might attack. That's 7 damage. Have one. Yeah, I'm gonna attack. Let's race. I did basically trade 3 for 4, but in case they had like a Brazen Borrower, that would just be so much more damage. Yeah, this is the downside of that though. I felt if they had cards like that, they would have just played it last turn. They just didn't really make a whole lot of sense to me that they didn't. So I could try to play Finale, I could try to play Brainstorm, I could play Fateless Looting from the Graveyard. So many ways to play this. I think I want to play Finale though. X is 2, play a Braid, and play... I guess Iteration makes the most sense. Braid, kill this guy, they're gonna crack the Storm Tamer. Put one into your hand, so Finale goes in my hand. Although, am I going to have something to flash back? Brainstorm and Opt. I mean, Chart the Course might be better because it's just so much cheaper. Yeah, I'll actually take that. I'll exile the land and exile Finale. Okay, I guess that was not how that worked. Never mind then. Never mind. So I guess the second card you click on is the one that you put on the bottom. Okay. Dive down, okay, that's fine. They're under basically the abyss, so no big deal. I could try to bring back Phoenix, or I could just try to find a land. I think trying to find a land is probably better, but then I would just cast this after. Actually, let's attack first. I'm not gonna play the Pyromancer. I just wanna bring back the Phoenix. I'm gonna draw 2, then I'm gonna play Brainstorm. I'm just gonna try to find another land. And another spell. Well, now I'm kind of committed into this. Five lands out, two spells. So now I need to find... If I break, then it's pretty bad for my next turn. I'm still gonna do it, I think. All right, put two cards into your library. So I can play Steam Vents Untapped, play Iteration, take something into my hand. So I don't think I want this guy, and I'm gonna put this on the top. It doesn't really matter, I guess. I'll take this in my hand into your library. This is to say, like, on the bottom, exile. Okay, so next turn I can just play a Phoenix. Wait. I haven't played with this card in quite a while, and I completely forgot that it does that at the beginning of your combat. So my plan of drawing cards with this to make sure I don't get to discard actually backfired pretty hard, because I could have gotten two Phoenixes back into play. Okay. Okay. I could actually just lose this game now. That's really funny because of that. I guess we're gonna do this. Okay, pro tip, if you want to bring back Phoenixes, play spells in your first main phase. Got it. That's fine. So they can make the Theramander bigger, but I don't know if that really matters right now. Because at some point I can also just keep this guy back. I guess maybe for the video I should just... turn off audio. Okay. How about a little bit of sound, just so I can hear something as well. All right, I guess they can't really beat the 10-10. Yeah, this game would have been a lot easier if I just brought back the two Phoenixes, basically, but hey, we learned something new. Or not really new, but you know what I mean. So what do I get rid of? All the burn spells are great. Beacon Bolt should be great as well. So I think I'm going to board out Pyromancers because they're going to be slow on the draw. The tokens don't really do anything against their creatures. I should just board out like a few expensive cards because I'm bringing in a lot of 2-drops. Maybe one Iteration. I think I have too many removal spells in my sideboard though. Like way too many. Yeah, I have way too many removal spells. When I was building the sideboard, I was thinking that I'm going to have Lava Coil against Jund and a Braid against, you know, Jund Sacrifice, because they also have Witch's Oven, and there probably won't be too many matchups where I'm going to be boarding all of these together. But I think at this point I have way too many. Actually, Instant's better than Sorcery anyways. Finale is pretty expensive and just gets countered by Spell Pierce and makes me want to have that a little bit less. Other than that, I think I like everything else. I'll just board out one more Finale, I think. Although Finale is so good against them. It's just so good against everybody. I'll get rid of Beacon Ball. It's just so expensive. It's all the one drops and Spell Pierces. Having a 3-mana Sorcery Speed card on the draw is probably not good enough. Yeah, my sideboarding right now was just completely random. That's the downside of building a deck without really, you know, I changed some cards around, like all of a sudden now I have like no real plan of how many cards go in and out of every matchup, which is something you should always do before playing for something. I'm gonna keep the Fateless Looting. Yeah, I'll just play Spire Blast, Canal Pass. If they want to put something on the Theramander, I can Lightning Axe. If not, I'll just play Opt, try to find a Phoenix. Sure. I kind of want all the cards in my hand, but I guess Opt is the worst, because Brainstorm with fetch lands grade. If they have a protection spell, then I can just play a Braid in my turn. Ooh, Phoenix is nice. So let's kill this guy so they don't get to draw more cards. Better to do it on your own turn, because if you pass, they're going to have more hexproof things and all that stuff. Now the question is, do I play looting right now? Do I go for Brainstorm plus fetch land? Do I try to hit another land, another spell? What's the play? I think I just play this and pass, actually. That's fine. Oh, my Brainstorm gets disputed. Okay. I think I normally don't crack the Fable Passages because you have Brainstorm in your deck, but I think right now it probably makes sense because I have another one and I just want to try to hit like 2 more 1-mana spells. Okay, that works as well. I could play Charticors first, but I guess it's kind of the same thing. So yeah, let's play Looting first. So I still need a 1-mana spell. So we're discarding this for sure. They got priority when I was casting, I was cracking Fabled Passage. So I probably have the 1-1 flash guy. So I'm gonna try to resolve strategic planning, I think. Probably discard the dragon. Let's see if they have another dispute. If I find another one mana spell, I'm going to be able to play the Fabled Passage, crack it. Yeah, you have another Dispute. Okay. Probably keep the Fabled Passage in my hand. Although, no, I'll play it, I think. Yeah, Double Dispute was certainly very, very good there. No reason to crack the land. I might attack so that I can draw two, because that gives me the highest odds of... They're never going to block, and this way I get to draw two, and that just gives me the highest odds of bringing back Phoenixes next turn, because I just need more cards. Oof. Okay, I'm still going to play one of those lands, even though I have Looting in the graveyard, because I still need to play three spells in a turn, and if one of them is a three mana card, then I think I need more than that. Lofty Denial, that's okay. So that was first spell, second spell. I guess we just need to find another Phoenix. Looting, okay. So Phoenix comes back, and now the question is, how do we attack? It might be just Phoenix attacks, might be just Sprite attacks. Might be both attack, which I think would be too aggressive. I think it's just the Phoenix. If they play Curious Obsession, then they would make this guy a 5-4 and I wouldn't be able to block. Now I probably wait a little bit on the Fateless Lootings. They have 1, 2, 3. Oh, they can already make the guy bigger. Okay. Already make it a 5-5, so I can trade for it next turn. So I guess I'm passing. Well, they chose not to do it? Interesting. Maybe I looked wrong at the number of cards they have in the graveyard. Mystical Dispute, that's fine. So what do you think of just killing the Cutthroat? You can play Lightning Axe. I guess I can play Opt first to try to find another Phoenix. Yeah, I'm just gonna do that, I think. If I hit another Phoenix, then I can just discard it. Yeah, it's pretty good. Pretty good, I guess. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Oh, now they have 5. I looked at Curiosity and thought it was an instant. So now they can make it bigger. I can also just not play Lightning Axe. I can only play Pillar, kill the Theramander, and attack with Phoenix. I think, yeah, I'm gonna keep it, I think. I actually kind of almost want to attack with both. No, let's just play it fat. Let's just play it safe. I don't think they can really beat an 8-8 flyer. All right, so first game showed that we need to actually look at the sideboard. I think I'll play like one more strategic planning over one of those iterations. And maybe I should have like an anti-graveyard card. People have been playing Lantern. Maybe Lantern could be okay. I think I have way too much removal. Also, this sideboard viewer is just, yeah. I also probably don't need that many lava coils. Now that I have the four lightning axes, probably no need for that, but I'll just leave it like this for now and change more as we play more matches. Like right now I found I had too many cards for creature decks, but I don't really know what I want. Maybe I want Mystic and Dispute. Yeah, Dispute's probably better than Spell Pierce because Dispute counters Torrential Gear. Yeah, I should have Dispute over Spell Pierce, I think. I would have also been able to bring in Dispute against the mono blue guy. Yeah, looks good. All right, let's play the slow. Kill the one drop. Looks like elves, obviously. As soon as I cut all the Anger of the Gods and Sweltering Suns from the sideboard, we're playing against elves. I think we have to kill that. Although I don't think it's that big a deal if we give our opponent one extra token. Yeah, we're gonna be making tokens as well. Let's leave it alive for a turn. I might regret this, but let's leave it alive for one turn. Okay, there's gonna be a lot of tokens. Interesting offer, but I'm gonna say no. So I guess now we're gonna try to find Phoenixes. A Braid does kill one of them. Yeah, I guess I'll keep that. There's a good reason why they say that this deck is as good as how many Phoenixes you have at the top, you know, 10 cards of your deck. Guess I don't really need to play it right now. But if I let them untap, play land company in response to my braid, oof. Yeah, I might just do it. I'm just gonna do it right now. If I let them play company, they company into two lords, then this is not even gonna do anything. That's a lot of War Masters. If you're the opponent, you don't really want to be attacking here because you have a lot of lords in your deck and you have the Shepherd ready to just activate it. So it doesn't really make sense to trade the creatures here. All right, let's find Phoenixes. Let's go. Oof.
Can't play the canal. I mean, I guess I can, but it comes into play tapped. So no matter what I do, I won't be able to. I can get two cards out of it by playing only Brainstorm and a tapped land. I don't think that's good enough. I'm gonna get a Brainstorm in my hand. I guess. Yeah, I'll play the Brainstorm first, try to find. A Phoenix. Okay, that didn't work. So we discard Canal and I guess Brainstorm. Probably have to Lightning Axe the Shepherd, otherwise they can get 6 mana activated. Yeah, I have to do it. We can pass now. No Phoenix yet, which is a pretty big problem because the 1/1s are not that great against somebody who's making their own 1/1s every turn. Well, if they have company, I guess I'm gonna get screwed. Oh, no attack. Okay, now they figured it out. All right, now we're doing it. No, let the one drop. No. Oh my god. One of them into your hand. I guess we need this one. Oh, I do. Oh my god, I did the same thing again. I wanted to exile the 2/1 guy. Not that it matters, but. Well, I guess we need to find a land. That's what it is. Okay, Phoenix in the graveyard. And I suppose Pyromancer in the graveyard? No, I guess double Pyromancer is pretty good. I'm just gonna do it like this. Yeah, this one's attacking. I think it's pretty likely they cast company here and then they just try to go for like a big attack next turn, but I don't think I can do much about that. Yeah, that's unfortunate. We only found one Phoenix so far in like 30 cards. It put a bunch of cards on the bottom. Some cards got exiled. Some cards got shuffled back. That's a lot of tokens. That's for free. Oh, now any lord is just basically good game. Okay, because if they want to trade the tokens, that's fine with me. Well, if my opponent's letting me trade the creatures, then I'll take it. Blog, 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 blog. Do as many trades as possible. Because trades are good for me. Pillar of Flames. I get to go Pyromancer, Pillar this guy. Yeah, that's all right, I guess. Make two tokens. And I think now we're just passing. Because I don't think I can even attack with the flyer. Because now I just need to block and just like hope that I draw into like a spell, Faithless Looting. Maybe chain like a bunch of phoenixes from the top of my deck into the graveyard. We'll see, I guess. They already have 7 lands, although... So I am probably just dead because they can activate Warmaster. All they need is to just stab the Visionary. Ooh, okay. Yeah, that should be good enough as well. All right. So all the removals coming in again, I guess. I don't know if I need Lightning Axe specifically. Like, it's good if I have Phoenix in my hand, but not very good if I don't have it. Because I don't really have other creatures to discard outside of that. On the play, I think I'll just get rid of the Pyromancers, because the tokens, like, they won't be able to attack because their creatures are going to be bigger, and they shouldn't really be able to block either. So I just want to kill them with flyers. Let's try it like this. Maybe again, Beacon Bolt is just too expensive. Maybe Beacon Bolt just shouldn't be in the sideboard. It just doesn't really seem like a historic card. It was okay in standard as like a one-off against the decks with big creatures, but here it doesn't really seem all that great. It's low, but I guess we can keep it. Now having a Lightning Axe would be great. Yeah, this deck is gonna be really hard to tune. Like, finding the perfect mix of cards, the perfect mix of, you know, removal spells, cards that discard from your hand, like all of that stuff is going to be really, really hard. Again, I could play the fetch land first. I could keep it so that I have 3 untapped lands on turn 3, which if I start with this, I don't have a guarantee of that. But I think it's probably fine to do it like this to play strategic planning on turn 2. This is where having the Anger of the Gods or Sweltering Suns would be really, really important. Because now that I don't have the cheap removal spells, I'm just going to fall very far behind on board if they have this kind of draw again. All right, we drew a Lightning Axe. So I guess right now we can just go Fabled Passage, kill the Llanowar Elf. Discard a card, discard a Phoenix. Pass. Should have actually played this, I think. Because then if I play Iteration next turn, I want to find a land and play the land. But if I do it, then this comes into play tapped on the next turn. So that actually was kind of bad. Ooh, okay. I'm going to find red now that I have the double red card in my hand. Yeah, I don't really know if I can do this. Strategic planning, look for a 1-mana spell. All right, we found 3. So I guess I take Opt.
Kotsure. Kotsure.
Fighting a box. I don't really think I want Pillar of Flame, because I don't want to target their creatures ever, basically, for the rest of the game. I could take Pillar and just shoot them, but I think Opt is probably the best. Let's hope we find another Phoenix. Scavenging Ooze. Oh, crap. No! Oh my god. You hate to see it.
So this is going to remove my ooze, and I'm going to need to kill it and give them two cards. Not good, not good. Hopefully they do it now, so I can actually cast my finale. Yeah, otherwise I wouldn't even be able to cast that card. Brainstorm. I guess I can cast this for one, targeting Axe and Pillar. No, Pillar doesn't work. So I have to cast Axe and Looting. And discard something like a Brainstorm. Maybe I find a fetch land. Lava Coil. So many options. Put two cards back. I guess we're not playing Finale right now. This is going to be a rough game. I can basically never target their creatures anymore, although I kind of have to, and I can only really damage them with flying. So this is going to be tough. If they ever draw like a collected company, I'm just super dead. Yeah, this was one of those games where like you just don't find a Phoenix and you just don't do anything. Like I didn't have a sprite on turn two. I guess I did find one Phoenix, but my opponent was ready with their creature. Do Pillar and Opt. I think I just need to put this into play. I can do Pillar face, Opt to draw cards, trying to find a Phoenix or something. I'm just super dead. There's no way I can win this game. Yeah, there is essentially no way. Taking seven. So if I play Finale and I go for Looting and Opt, I opt first, try to find two Phoenixes. There's no way I can play enough spells this turn to make that work. I mean, let's try. Opt, Looting. Card to cast. So hopefully this is, how does this work? No, you click on the first one you click is the last card you cast. So that was unfortunately the other way around. Discard this and yeah, I'm going to be playing this anyway, I guess. Yeah, Finale's okay, I guess. If I attack with just Sprite Dragon, that's present to 13. I jump with the Phoenix, hope they don't kill me. Although that's impossible, they just stab the Archdruid and I'm dead in like a million ways. I mean, I guess I just know, I have to hope that they don't find it. It's unlikely, but it's a plan. A lot of power. That's a lot of power you got there, my friend. I'm also just dead to the board. All right. Yeah, without the sweeper, you're probably never gonna be favored in this matchup. All right, so let's probably cut like a removal spell or two and just replace them with the Sweltering Suns again. Because I do have way too much removal. I think the Beacon Bolt is just too bad. It's just too expensive. I mean, it's cool to have something you can keep playing from the graveyard,
but so far it doesn't look like we had a problem with just running out of gas or anything. So Sweltering Suns, Beacon Bolt, and probably the Aux is also not super necessary. Maybe three Lightning Axes is good enough. All right, let's play one more.
Tylko tutaj prowadzić. Dobra, dar. Hello.
Up. Up. Let me remind you that Channel Fireball is doing this thing called Box Breaks. I actually was gifted one of the slots in the Box Breaks yesterday. The way it works is you just split a box or multiple boxes with other collectors, and they divide the cards into, you know, random groups. Yesterday I was getting red cards and lands, I believe, and we opened a box of Strixhaven and a collector box of Strixhaven, and there was a lot of really good cards, but all of them was black, and Alias V completely cleaned up the entire box break with like a foil Demonic Tutor from the Mystical Archive, Tainted Pact, a couple of Professor Onyxes. It was pretty good. Not a lot of very good red cards, but it was fun. And, you know, somebody is always getting the short end of the stick. So yeah, it was fun. If you want to check it out, you can go to channelfireball.com and look up Box Breaks at the website. Normally don't like doing this without any value, so I might actually just keep it in my hand for like future use. Yeah, there's really no reason to cast it right now. It's just basically going to be one mana draw a card, which don't really need right now. Oh, there's a Brainstorm. Look at that. Another option as far as creatures go in this deck is the 5 mana 3/3 that if you play a spell, it costs 3 less. Which is a nice way to... Which is a nice way to... get a cheap flyer to play. Baffling End. So kind of want to cast Iteration, but I would need to get a land and a one mana spell, which I guess is okay, but I kind of just want to get like a creature out of this. Actually, no, I don't need to play the spell. It doesn't. Ooh, so I need to put Phoenix in my hand. One on the bottom, an exile one, and now I just need to play the Fateless Looting, I suppose. One, two. All right, so next turn we're gonna try to get three spells. I'm gonna start with Strategic Planning. Ooh, Pyromancer is nice as well. I guess I can save this for post. Oh, I should have also played the Canal and not the Steam Vents, because now it comes into play tapped, which is kind of a big deal, actually. Yeah, let's start with Strategic Planning. I'm going to play Brainstorm afterwards. Then play the Fabled Passage, crack it. Hopefully find a one land. Oh, we bricked on a one land spell. Oof. That's rough. Canal goes back. Steam Vent goes back. That's actually pretty rough, bricking on a one land spell here. Yeah, so far, like, we haven't really been doing anything too crazy. I mean, I'm just trying out the deck. It's gonna be a hard deck to tune, but you need the hands where you go like turn one Fadeless Looting, discard double Phoenix, you know, bring it back on turn three. It's possible that you shouldn't really bother with the other creatures. Like you shouldn't maybe bother with the Young Pyromancer. Maybe you shouldn't bother with the Dragon Sprite. Like maybe those cards are just not good enough. I'm not really sure just yet. I actually can't really cast three spells this turn, huh? So I guess I go for Pyromancer into Finale. I guess let's do it in the right order now. With Brainstorm, I have one more card to try to find Phoenix in. But Fadeless Looting gets me deeper. I play Looting. Yeah, let's do it this way. Get some tokens. No Phoenix. So I want to put back. I guess it doesn't really matter because I'm going to draw the cards anyway. So yeah, let's just put something back. Okay. Draw the same cards. Probably discard both. Actually, I'll discard a Braid. A Braid's good against Cage, but I have another one in the deck. Yeah, let's discard a Braid. So next turn, if I play another Finale, I can get Iteration, and there's no good instant outside of a Braid. Okay, so let's try to find something nice. Opt in my hand, this goes at the bottom, this gets into exile. I guess I can go Pyromancer, Opt, Phoenix. Pyromancer, Opt, yeah, that works. Brainstorm, I'm sure that's good enough. All right, we put them to 11. If they have another Wrath effect, gonna need to do it all over again. There is a Doomscar. All right, no problem. We can do it again. All right, this looks good. So, Pillar back and Island back, or Island back for sure, and we can fetch to shuffle. I don't really want to play more lands though, and keeping a spell is pretty good when you want to just play three spells. I guess I'm gonna do it, but don't love it. I do want to find another Phoenix though. Like finding another Phoenix would be huge. I also have one last land in my deck to fetch, I think. Oh, I do have one last land to fetch. Yeah, that was not good. I should have discarded.
Yeah, I should have not done that. Like, now this just sets me back a line. No reason to really cast anything else. Just want to make sure that I get to cast three spells next turn. I could have actually maybe discarded the Fadeless Looting. But this is also okay. Well, puts them to five. It's really, really hard for their deck to deal with the Phoenixes because they keep coming back. They can't Baffling End it. If you play Wrath, well, you just have to Wrath it again next turn. The more I find, the harder it is for them to really get anything going, because even if they play Teferi, I can just either attack it or ignore it. Maybe they're even forced to just put one back into my deck, but that's not really a big deal because we have the Fadeless Looting ready. Yeah, that's not going to work very well for them. Ooh, hello. Choose one to put into your hand, okay. I don't know if there is some like holiday in the format, but I'll just make sure I attack the Planeswalker as well. And holiday might actually just prevent everything anyway. All right, so blue-white control did a whole lot of nothing. A whole lot of counter spells and wrath or whatever, but none of that actually stopped the Phoenixes. So Ox should be good. I think I want the Abrades because that deals with Cage, but it doesn't deal with Rest in Peace. Like, this is the downside of playing without open deck lists. I have no clue what my opponent's going to do as far as sideboard goes. And I don't really love the Abrades, but there's no way they don't have at least one Cage. I can discard them to Looting. Yeah, I'm going to have two, I think. I need to get rid of one card. Well, let's just have one. Yeah, pretty good hand. No Phoenix again, though. You can't really mulligan into it. Like, this is not like playing Black-White Auras where, you know, finding your core Spirit Dancer is just like the absolutely most important thing. I don't really feel like I should play this. Or the Brainstorm. Mindstone, okay. I could just use them to make the sprite bigger. Or to like set up bringing back Phoenixes. If I already had a Phoenix and I was looking for, you know, Fateless Looting, then I would probably cast it turn one. Or if I had a Fateless Looting and I was looking for Phoenixes, I would also do that. But with this hand, I don't really know what I'm looking for. I guess I was also looking for Young Pyromancer. Yeah, maybe I could have cast it. Cycle this on their main phase. That is strange. Yeah, now they don't deal with the sprite, I'm going to have a negate open, so now I can do this and opt. I don't want another land. There was no reason to play the land first, I suppose.
Yeah, now they play the Teferi, I can negate it. Hopefully now I just sit back on counters and just find more counters with all the search, with all the card selection spells. Brainstorm and fetch land, yeah, don't mind if I do. But then I can't play the iteration, so maybe it's just... I want to find a counter spell. That's the most important thing I want to do this turn. I think I'll just wait with the iteration. Start with the brainstorm. Just put two lands back, keep Fabled Passage. But I don't really have any counter spells, so I guess I'm going to be casting Strategic Planning, hope to find a one mana spell and a Phoenix. That works, I guess. So shuffle these two back. Get an island, planning. No Phoenix, but Fateless Looting can get me there. It's a lot worse than Brainstorm, but if I find the Phoenix, it'd be so good. It's just top two though. No, I'll take the Brainstorm, I think. Maybe I just take the planning. Yeah, I'll take the planning. That's the best at finding Phoenixes. A lot of two mana cards though. Narset's pretty good. It doesn't really stop this though. It's not really drawing cards. Neither is Strategic Planning. So it doesn't actually do a whole lot as far as stopping me from drawing cards. Oof. Ay, 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 ay. That's a good one. Yeah, so this card does... Okay, maybe I should have boarded out one finale because of this. Because of Rest in Peace and like other ways to stop me from playing cards in the graveyard. I don't even know if I can play Pyromancer. I kind of just don't want to do it. Because if I get Wrath, it's going to be so bad. I need to kill this regardless. I think I'm going to... No, I'll just keep it in my hand. Up to my hand, on the bottom, exile. I think I just passed the turn. I don't really want to play into the sweepers. And like now, even if I find Phoenix, I can just attack with it. So it's not that bad. That's fine. Having only Dragon in play is bad against the Teferi, but if they had the Teferi, they would have played it last turn instead of the Narset, so. Sure. Into your hand. Guess we're gonna go with the iteration on the library and this one. All right, I still need to find like a negate or something. That's the, okay, here, into your hand. Attack for 8. All the creatures are going to be better against like different decks. I think what we played against so far Maybe having Soulscar Mage would have been better than just like having like Young Pyromancer, for example. It's also something you can play on turn one, which I think is really important. Just like having a turn one creature. Because you don't really want to play most of the other cards in turn one. Like, you don't really want to play Brainstorm turn one because you want to save it for the turn when you crack a fetch land. You only want to cast Looting when you have Phoenix in your hand and... What was the last card? Optus Finder to cast turn one, obviously. But so far, and maybe having just like too many twos is just not good, and having a Soulscar Mage would have been better. Yeah, I think they're dead. I think in the eyes attacks for a lot more and a lot better than like both of these guys, because it also just bounces their board. So that was a big card for... the modern deck, I feel like. It also had just card like, you know, Gutshot and like Mutagenic Growth. You were able to cast cards for free. The zero mana Extirpate, the Phyrexian mana thing. What else did that deck have? Yeah, I mean, I feel like this deck is okay. Like, it's also really good at grinding. Like, for example, like this blue-white control deck, like they can't really do much. Like game one, you just keep bringing Phoenixes. Like, you don't really do it. You don't need to cast, you know, 17 spells in one turn or anything. You just cast three spells, then keep the rest in your hand. Don't actually play anything. Deck with Phoenixes. If you deal with it, I'm just going to do it again. I'm just going to do it again. And then, like, they can't really do much. But if you're playing against a deck that doesn't want to interact with you, like elves, we got steamrolled pretty quickly because they don't really care about a 3-2 flying that comes into play even on turn three. And they just kill you with a much bigger board. So this deck is going to require a lot of tuning, a lot of, yeah, this should be Mystical Dispute, I think. A lot of tuning, a lot of, you know, playing with it, just trying to get a feel for the metagame. And right now it's definitely just version one and there isn't really even a metagame. It's definitely great against rogues, because if they mill you, that's great for you. Like, you can keep playing these lootings from the graveyard, and it fuels your finale. Phoenix is coming back and everything. So it's good against probably the most popular deck right now, but it's still historic. Like, there's a million decks that people are playing. But yeah, I mean, if you like this deck, just give it a try. Definitely, it's been a while for me since I played it last time, so I, you know, didn't remember that it only comes back before. Compat, for example, I wanted to do it after, that didn't work, so a little bit rusty, but it's been a while since Phoenix and Looting were legal in a format like this. So my overall grade for the deck would just be like, yeah, it's a fine deck and there's a lot of potential. It's definitely not super well tuned at the moment, but it has a lot of potential. It's a good deck, it's good at grinding, but if your opponent doesn't want to interact with you, then you're probably not going to be great against like some kind of combo decks that just, you know, want to kill you on turn three or four. You're going to be sitting there with Lightning Axe and Strategic Planning in hand, and neither of those are going to be very useful in the matchup. So it just depends on what the metagame looks like, I guess. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you next time.